What is going on? Where are my ramenites at? This is your main man from Philly. Always imitated, never duplicated, refuse to be assimilated, Daddy T. Now today we are joined with a special guest of mine, Rob Jones. Who? Rob Jones. Who? Rob Jones. And before you ask, yes, his mixtape is coming out soon, so look forward to that. Now, he had a bad experience with ramen, but not at this spot. He claimed the ramen smelled like straight, I won't say just in case your kids are watching this, but let's just say it rhymes with gas, okay? Now, what he had was tonkotsu-based ramen. Today, we are visiting one of my favorite, and I do mean this sincerely, favorite chains. It is also my father-in-law's absolute favorite chain in all of Japan. Kagestu Arashi. Sorry, I had to say it like that. I can't help it. Now let's get something to eat and let me show you a sweet dish you won't find in any other ramen chain. At least I haven't. But first, don't forget to subscribe by hitting the subscribe button below this video or the small red square at the bottom right corner of this video. Or follow us on Instagram or Twitter at DaddyTJapan. Now when you first come in here, you'll see a ticket machine with each dish having its own button. So I usually see foreigners come in here confused, and understandably so. I mean, there's no English support, but not to worry, I'm here for you. Now I can't go over every button because it's going to keep changing, but I will break it down a little something something for you, because that's what I do on my channel, looking out for you. So notice the red bar kanji here. These are Arashi originals. And with these, you can choose the base, whether it be miso, shoyu, or shio. There is no tonkotsu here, which is one of the reasons I brought Rob Jones, who? Rob Jones, here to change his whole negative outlook on ramen. Now, we'll see if that works later. Okay, so to the right of the red kanji label is the black label. You cannot change the base of these ramens. The second row, these are seasonal items here. Below that are rice platters, soft drinks, and beers. The change button is on the bottom right. It says otsuri in Japanese, meaning change. Now I'm going to choose the garlic butter rice plate, and I'll get a spicy ramen also with a cola.
Get your hands out my pockets.
He chose the chashumen. After you're done, just take the tickets with you to your table and hand them to the lady or gentleman. So this place was actually founded in 1992 in Tokyo, and they have over 230 locations nationwide. This particular one is located in Yokosuka City, Kanagawa-ken, at the address below. This is a spicy Chinese chive called nira. Now there was a Kagestu Arashi out in Kurihama, but that one is gone, and now this is the only one that I know of in Yokosuka. Womp womp. Now, I've heard that there's one out in Kanazawa-hake, but not to worry, they're all over Japan, to include Okinawa. So don't worry, you can find one if you Google it. Just type Kagestu Arashi. This is a manly ramen spot, if you couldn't tell by now. Now, I don't know that much kanji. I do know a fair share, but here's the easy one for you. This kanji symbol is the symbol for water. High quality H2O. And like I said, just hit him up if you want a mixtape, you want some beats made, or if you just have a computer problem, he can do all that. Rob Jones. Now this is actually called Yukari. Now this is a shiso or plum furikake. Nothing special here, just vinegar. This sauce is called Ryu. So yeah, you've seen this in some of my other ramen videos perhaps. Ryu adds a little kick, as if I need it. Now this plate was actually made to symbolize what your tummy is going to look like after eating this spicy ramen I ordered. Just kidding, don't be scared. Do they still say that? Oh man, this is what's up right here. I need this in my life. Now this is a rice platter unique to Kagestu Arashi. And this is a garlic buttered flavored rice plate. You mixed up yourself and it's good with some beers. Heck, I'm drinking one right now while I'm making this video. Drink them if you got them. And actually sometimes when you come here to try to get one of these, they're actually sold out. I remember coming here twice a week just for this plate and they didn't even have it in stock. You'd be a fortunate soul to taste one of these. This is Daddy T recommended. Now this is RJ's chashumen. I think he'll like this a lot better than whatever you ordered before, wherever you ordered it. Remember folks, not all ramen is created equal, and I mean that. I had to represent for the YKO so that he didn't go back to USA saying ramen was crap in Japan. I think I succeeded. And of course, this is my spicy ramen. Look at that, see what I'm saying? Ramen's so good, made my man take off his glasses. That's what we do at Daddy T Productions. We bridge those gaps. それは惜しかったな。ごちそうさま。 Yahari. Now you see this bowl? Y'all think he changed his mind about ramen in Japan? I don't even drink all the soup. That's impressive. Good job, RJ. Hope you enjoyed this episode and tune in next week and I'll have another one up for you. It's completely random. It could be anything. And that's what makes this channel fun. There will be another one. Alright, now go on ahead and have some fun. But come back now, okay? See you on the next one. DT out. Rob Jones. Who? Rob Jones. Who? Rob Jones.